Monday mornings, back on the grind. Got Mr. Rod Bell, Bell Rod.
Is that good?
Yeah.
And Miss Moto Model. So, in California for another week?
Till Sunday.
Till Sunday.
Fly back to Maryland. And then back to North Carolina.
Yeah.
Finally.
Do anything fun out here?
It's our birthdays this week.
Yeah.
Both of them?
Yeah.
You guys both have birthdays this week.
Yeah,
big birthdays.
How old are you going to be?
22.
You?
24.
20. Oh, you're robbing the cradle, huh? Cougar.
How we doing though?
So are you celebrating this week? What are you doing?
We're gonna save it for next week.
Save it for next week when you're home?
Yeah. Well, on the way home, I think we'll go to Vegas.
Oh.
Yeah.
Vegas.
Just for the night?
Yeah.
And then
go big.
Yeah, just one night.
One day at the pool though, right?
Yeah, day and night.
You gotta give her the chance to like wear that thong at the pool.
Come on.
No, he's always like, no.
Wear one piece, cover up. it's Tuesday and we're starting off the day with a ride with Victor Sheldon, the slasher.
Yo, what's up?
435 time jet ski champ. You could show Chase a thing or two. You know, that's his latest obsession right now.
Who's that?
Chase Curtis, my video guy.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he bought a 550 that has a 650 engine wedged in it.
Nice.
And, it's got this replica PJS paint job on it, but it's like pink and blue instead.
Dude, all those old paint jobs are coming back. So.
Yeah. How many, do you have any old skis?
I do.
Do you have a 550?
I have two 550s and one 750.
Oh, 750, that's later on, right?
And they're all old race boats, so.
Yeah, we just picked up a XXS 4500 or some gigantic four-stroke.
Dude, the new Cowies are huge.
Yeah.
And they're heavy.
Yeah, it wouldn't fit on his trailer, so we had to get a different trailer.
I'm sorry, but I'm not a big fan of the big boats.
No, yeah, he says it's the tuna boat.
Yeah, it's the new times, right?
Yeah, but yeah.
I still like the old times.
Yeah. So where are we riding? And what's the trail like? Are you going to kill me?
No.
Okay.
No. What do you always say? What do you always say?
Do not resuscitate.
Just let me go. I'm doing
These aren't all yours, right? Some of these are racer.
Raw machines. Johnny Gamara's.
Wait, what is this one? That's an Osho helmet?
Yeah.
Dude, wait a sec. Wait a sec. Number 9. I knew it. Oh, dude. Chad Reed.
Chad Reed.
So that's yours?
Yeah.
Lachine. No way. How'd you get that, dude? How'd you get that?
Yeah.
Does he know you have it?
Oh, yeah. He gave it to me before he lost it.
Wow.
Dang, his little escapades. Reedy's
up there. Who's Red Bull Thorum?
That's mine, but I have Pastrana's, too.
And then this one.
Pastrana's? This is Pastrana's.
Oh, when he wore our eyes.
Yeah.
He kept getting knocked out, so he wore an eye. Whose is this? Is this yours?
That's mine.
Okay, that's yours?
Yep. That's one of Ronnie's, too. I think this is when he was kind of done.
Oh, JT, yeah.
Yeah, so.
That's yours? You raised skis in that one, right?
Yep.
Troy Lee. Thor. That's a showy jet ski helmet.
Yeah, yeah. Never wore it.
Dude, no vent in the front.
Look at this thing. Like, this is never wore it. Brush factory.
So that was a jet ski helmet. There was this Coop Pro guy at CMC that wore that. And
raced moto in it?
Moto. I wonder if it was a different technology or if it's the same. It just had a jet ski.
I think it had like the insides was a little bit like, I don't know, different material.
Yeah. Okay. Slammer.
I got a lot of good old Troy Lee helmets, man.
Yeah. So sick to ride for Troy, huh? That was the first full face show.
That one right there?
Yeah, the ugliest helmet ever made.
It was.
Jeff Ward wore that.
And then it transitioned to...
Actually, you know, the first one had more lines.
And then it transitioned to that.
That one. That was this was the most copied helmet ever, because all the KBC and MSR and all the companies copied. Did you wear those? Did you wear those in the water?
In the very beginning, yeah. I didn't really like them. But...
Yeah. So when you wore a moto helmet in the water, would it get heavy when it got wet?
It would.
And so did you do anything to the liners or anything?
I would just bring extra liners. So switch them out. Switch out dry liners.
Well, I guess it wouldn't get wet unless you fell or got splashed.
Yeah. In a moto, but when you'd come back.
Yeah.
You know, once you got to... once you had a few liners and it made it a lot nicer to switch them out, dry them out.
Nice.
Because they would get heavy.
Yeah. Oh, look at that.
I wonder if Chase would just be pumped on that.
Look at the model life.
Oh, yeah.
And then this, look how faded that cover is. Is it because of the sun coming in? Remember I worked there?
Yeah.
Because it was cycle news also.
Yeah. And Paul Carruthers too.
Yeah. And then the vintage display.
Yeah, there's some good stuff in there.
M frames.
That's when we used to go in there and take as many glasses.
Eye shades. Those are coming back. Sub Zeros just came back, right?
Yeah. Yeah. This thing's probably worth some dough, man.
This is a history
lesson. The back.
Is it really?
Oh,
the stock.
I mean, we used to go in there with Mike Bell and just literally just grab
whatever you wanted.
Just make mumbos and, you know, the blades.
Yeah.
Just build them different colors and it was so much fun.
Yeah, I like this one. Is this the one where the sides went out?
Yeah. Yeah. M-frame? Yeah. That was so comfortable.
That was a good one.
I put one of those on the other day and I was unbelievable.
Still good.
You still how comfortable they were.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's hard for them to, you know.
So is this like where you do the entry forms for Quick and Dirty and sign up the class list and all that?
Yep. I mean.
Dude, mountain bike race promoter. When does Quick and Dirty resume?
October 29th. Filthy 50.
How much elevation?
33,400 feet. 50 miles, which is not a lot.
Is it Cat 3 class?
Yeah. Sport?
No. Is there beginner class? All
right, beginner. There's expert, beginner, and sport.
And October then, what?
October 29th.
All right, I'll be there.
Okay.
I'm going to do it.
Come on.
I said it on the vlog. I'm going to do it.
Yep.
You're going to hold me accountable.
It's on. It's out there, so.
Okay, so we have a podcast to do.
Yeah.
All right, it's Wednesday and we're at Parrish Raceway. It's supposed to be 106 today. Kawasaki's giving us our 2023 KX250. And everybody's here. I've got Pat Foster and Rene Garcia to do the testing, so I don't have to ride because it's gonna be too damn hot. But lots of content to be had today. Here's the other 48. Toyota of Redlands.
Yeah, what up?
Toyota of Redlands. Why does your truck look cooler than Talon's?
Because I'm cooler than Talon's.
Yeah, he has that goofy off-road crap.
Can I just wear my earlobe? Is that fine?
I think that's fine. Yeah.
You're trying to gather me up?
Yeah,
it's like herding cats, you know?
It is, you know?
I'm like a cat.
You're always the worst. You're so difficult. Like.
I read the presentation. I don't need to hear it. I read the PDF.
I want you to hear it again, though.
Okay, I'll be over there.
Morning,
Cam Mac.
What up?
The other 48.
I'm the other guy.
You know, Club 48 is pretty cool. It's me, you, Will Hahn, Christian Craig.
Oh, wow. I'm projected to be 48 again next year.
Really?
That's what they say right now, but That's fun. I don't really score much points this weekend.
Oh, dude, you're going to be on podium this weekend.
I want to be 44 next year.
44, sick. That's fours are good numbers.
I had 44.
You know who else is 48?
2019. Who?
Marchbanks.
Marchbanks, that's my guy.
Huh?
That's my guy.
Marchbanks is your guy? Yeah, he was your guy training at Club Moto?
Yeah, we trained there together for a while. Whenever he was on like a Super Mini.
Yeah.
Dude, he was really fast on a Super Mini. Wow.
Yeah. All right. I'm not riding today, so you don't.
You get a new Epic Evo after you saw mine at the
yeah,
shop.
Yeah, dude, it was sick.
I feel like you have a new bike like every couple months.
No, once a year. Once a year, dude.
Once a year, dude.
Dude, what's with the dirty helmet?
It'll be clean. Don't worry. Hey, dude, don't blow me out. Huh? Come on, helmet. Don't blow me out.
Is that race dirt though? No, it's training.
No, that's yesterday's Glen Helen. Mm. And then I like go in. I don't ever start my day with a dirty helmet. Yeah. That's something I won't do.
Is it hard right now at this point in the season with one race left to go out and smash motos?
No, it's never hard for me. Like,
yeah, you've always 100% cam, right?
It's like, I never struggle to find motivation to like, I don't know, I love it.
This is true.
It's awesome, this is true. You know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, okay, like, I'm not going to act like, oh, it's never hard for me to find motivation. Like, on a Friday, after a long week, waking up is tough, but then you're like, I get to go ride dirt bikes. Like, it's not that bad. It could be a lot worse.
Life's good.
Yeah, life's awesome. So definitely stay hydrated today. First off, I'm Ken Essex, manager of PR with Kawasaki. And as you can see, there's a number of black Team Green shirts here to support you guys. They're all here for you. And we've got many different divisions, so I wanted to take a chance to say thank you.
So there she is. First thing we do on a bike test day is film the bike breakdown presented by O'Neill. Today I'm doing it with Brad Pitts. I love doing Legends of the Fall, dude.
I cut my hair since
such
then.
A good movie. So let's go on down here. Got the microphone. There you go. Okay, so our Cowie tech today is Sean Borkenhagen. Borky, what? Let me think.
We're ready.
What was your number? 180 something?
I was 186.
186. I'm bummed I missed it, but I knew it was 180 something.
I had 187, 85, 63, and then the last year I raced, I was 186.
Nice. So, you are new in the media side coming from R&D, right?
Yeah.
What made you want to switch?
The test running was, it's great, and I still do it. As I'm getting older, I had to think about my future. I can't ride forever at mm-hmm. a certain level. I still feel like I'm at the same level as I've been, mm-hmm. but just an opportunity arose and I went for it.
Yeah. Nice.
So yeah, I'll be working with you guys, the media and the shootouts and intros. So
yeah, I'm super excited about that. We've been buddies forever, you know?
Yeah, I'm super excited about it as well. And just opening a new chapter of my life in mm-hmm. my career at Kawasaki.
Okay, so what year was that? Was it at Loretta's you got hurt?
Oh,
or where was it?
I got hurt bad in Texas.
In Texas.
I broke my collarbone pretty bad.
But your arm was like paralyzed or something for a while, right?
Yeah. In 06, my collarbone broke and it hit the nerves that come off your spinal cord and control your arm.
Mm-hmm.
And I stretched them. It's called the brachial plexus.
Uh-huh.
And I got super lucky because they just stretched and didn't sever.
Yeah.
And that was about 9 months of recovery.
Yeah. The crazy thing is, like, back then, were you worried that you were going to be messed up forever? Because, I mean, I remember your arm was like a chopstick.
Yeah, yeah. You know, it was bad. I remember thinking I was going to be living like that for the rest of my life. Mm-hmm. Because, I remember David Bailey helping me out with knowledge of spinal cord or just nerve damage in mm-hmm. general. And my mind was like all over the place with that whole thing, and it actually just started coming back slowly, and as time went on I thought, wow, like maybe I could ride again just mm-hmm. for fun, and then that escalated to where you kind of forget about the danger, you're just back in it.
Yeah.
And then I started racing professionally and I had the best like experiences after that injury. Mm-hmm. It's just crazy how life can go, I guess.
So curveball. So after racing, you're still working in the industry, riding dirt bikes. I mean, it's all worked out okay for you, I think.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I never thought I would land a job test riding. Mm-hmm. It's something everyone kind of strives for. And that's evolved to now I'm a technician in tech services at Kawasaki. Mm-hmm. I've been here for almost 8 years, and it just kind of fell into place. Like, I feel at home. I plan to be at Cali as a full career, so mm-hmm. it's been a great adventure so far.
Cool. Congrats, and looking forward to working with you for a long time.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Cat goes first. You got dressed too slow, dude.
I know, people got me.
Bro, tell me about Brock Eats, or what is Brock eating today? What is that about?
Well, during the week, I'm on a like meal prep. Not really prep, but I get meals delivered on Monday morning. So with how hectic my schedule's been and going to the races every weekend and traveling and all the above, I started getting meals delivered on Monday. So that made things easier during the week for me. But so on the weekends, on Saturday, I go after it. But B always has good food, always good snacks. The cooler's always full of like Perrier, which I drink a lot of that anyways. Yeah. But yeah, we get taken care of on Saturdays.
I like Shanti's Instagram.
Yeah, we need to.
And it's also Big B sometimes.
Yeah, it's Big B and Shanti basically that kind of got the idea together, because they saw how creative I would get with meals and with sandwiches and wraps and whatever it may be that I was making. So the guys kind of got a kick out of it, and we were like, let's just give it a shot. Yeah. So we had a little fun time there for Supercross doing that, but. I think maybe we can get another one this weekend. It's going to be hot, so maybe we'll be hanging out in the rig not doing much.
All right. So what do you think of your guy? You happy with this year?
Oh, it's been awesome. Since I started about a year ago with the team over here, it's been really, really good, I think, for myself. Just to be involved with the team, be working around people that I'm used to being around, I'm thankful for that opportunity. And I like giving feedback on the bike and testing, so it kind of goes all together. And then obviously helping Jason, I enjoy training, which I'm sure you're aware of and whatnot. And it's been awesome. The guy's gone, it's 9 wins total for the year. Let's see if we can make it 10 total for, so I'm excited for him. I think it's a rejuvenated Jason, I would say. I mean, I think the whole paddock can agree. I think with Eli being so good in Supercross as well, I think a little bit of credit got pushed towards him because of his change as well. And I think in my eyes, and I think the public's eyes looking at it, like, he's kind of done the same thing, you know? Kind of reset the bar for himself and put himself in a place where he's showing these guys he wants to be there and wants to win.
All right. 20's up for grabs next year, dude.
I'm keeping it.
Huh?
I'm keeping it.
Are you gonna race this weekend?
No.
I know, but I'm just saying, like, a pro could get it. No. Active race. No, you get one more year?
Yeah.
Oh. Is the dream still alive?
There's some exceptions that the AMA has made for a group of us.
Oh, nice.
I believe me, Chad, Osborne, and Colt Nichols all requested to keep their number for one more year. So I'm keeping 20 for another year. We don't know what the next year brings. This year we didn't get any racing in, but I would rather do it safely and keep it for one more year if I can. And then if the opportunity comes where it makes sense to race, then try to keep it, you know.
No,
what do you think of the
this is BTS?
The chest protector over the jersey.
Oh, I'll tell you the reason. Everyone keeps asking me why I run a chest protector over the jersey. I would run it under, but honestly, maybe a little bit too much information. But
nipples.
I keep having in my nipples, and I keep having breakouts on my back.
Oh.
So like, I just save it for race day.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I guess wearing another layer just makes you hotter, right?
Yeah, it's like when people used to wear a sweatshirt to get used to humidity.
Yeah.
It's kind of same shit.
Earplugs, is that new or is that always, have you always done that?
I ran earplugs when I was like 14.
Really?
Yeah.
Dude, I can't keep them in when I pull my helmet off.
Oh, you gotta put them deep.
Yeah.
Balls deep.
If you rode without earplugs, would you be like, fuck, it's too
oh,
hard?
Oh, I can't do it. Yeah, I can't ride without earplugs at all.
I know that the ECE helmets are a little louder too, right?
I never noticed except for earplugs. They're way lighter.
Do you sleep with earplugs?
I do sometimes.
On planes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But,
right there, yeah.
I will say, though, these helmets, it depends for each one, but they are louder. They've
yeah.
gotten louder.
Yeah.
But I've been with Aero for so long, I can't tell the difference.
You're used to it.
I think I'm like 11 years old. After that runner, you
kid to work?
I'm gonna let the kids get the grease off of the track.
Oh, so you're waiting.
I'm getting smarter as I get older, Don.
Smarter. Why?
I see what you're doing sometimes. I'm like, oh, I gotta fix something.
Well, I'm like, fuck, I'm not riding. I got enough of this place on Sunday.
That's right, you race.
Yeah, old timers shoot 20-minute moto.
18 plus one?
And you win?
Yeah.
Did you beat Biggie?
Huh?
Did you beat Biggie?
Oh, yeah. Hey, that fucker actually beat me up to start in the first moto. And on the start of the second lap, he went on a turn all cocky with his fist pumping. And I went inside and passed him.
Hey, I will say this. I've never seen a over 50-year-old guy
with it like that.
As much style as he has.
Yeah, his style's gotten better, too.
Yeah, I think so. Like, I had to do a double take one time because he scrubbed it over this tabletop right here.
Yeah.
And it looked legit.
Yeah, he throws it.
Yeah.
We came up to play one last time before sweating our balls off at Paula tomorrow. Could be one of those days. I forgot everything. Forgot my mountain bike helmet. Forgot my watch. Forgot my GoPro. Had a different GoPro in the truck. And I had a motocross helmet in the truck. So, I'm riding with Moto 10 today. As opposed to a full 10. I'm gonna look like a bobblehead. I didn't get the fourth one. Thank you.
Raceway National 2, 9,000 degrees. Parked way in the back. We're not getting out of here till Monday morning.
Yes, sir.
Who is that?
Jason Fichera.
Oh, he's racing the National.
Yes, sir. He's on his third bike of the year. It was white, then at Hangtown he was decided to race green, and now he's on blue.
And he lost a number. Wasn't he 412? Privateer paradise back here. So big day for you, bud.
Same day as always, buddy.
Same day as always.
That's not as
anxiety riddled as last year this day, right?
No, last year I was pretty nervous all day. Still there, but you gotta remember, it's just a normal Saturday.
Yeah. So they're making a big deal about the heat and everything. Bike wise, do you do anything different?
Not really. I mean, they practice all week long in Florida, and heat index is probably about the same as this, so
yeah.
Bikes are, we don't really do anything different for the bikes.
What's the plans tonight? Are you going to blow it up?
You know, probably. You don't really know, but it goes, you have a plan, then it never goes according to plan. You just kind of just fly by the seat of your pants at that moment. Yeah. So whatever happens goes, kind of.
So Pedro, you're the big newsbreaker, dude.
I watched your video. I did like it.
Huh? No, but you broke the news.
I did.
That's how we found out. Your Instagram.
That's what I do.
Huh? That's what you do.
No, I liked your suit, your video.
You should have.
The best was back at the station, reporter.
Yeah.
You need to get him on there more.
You should have seen Marvin's face when he opened the front door. So what the fuck?
That's probably the nicest suit you have, huh?
Oh, it is. It is.
Did you wear that at your daughter's wedding?
No, I used it. Do you know Casey Davis?
Yeah.
He married my niece.
Right. Oh.
I was the officiant.
Oh, okay.
That's what
you wore?
Yeah.
So that it was that special, the news break of Marvin Musquin to wear the same suit you were the officiant at your niece's wedding.
It was.
Nice. Pretty important.
Shit, there he is. What's up, dude?
Sweating, dude.
Yeah?
Sweating. I got a court date up. I'm sweating so tough. What's up?
Hey, you back on the program? You looking like fighting with me?
Yeah, that's what happens when you go out MIA. You ain't got no meals at home. I learned to cook for myself. It's a little light. It's a little light. My kids eat when they eat. Daddy ain't here. Y'all just eat whenever. It's good.
All right, so podcaster life, how is it? I remember when we talked after you first started,
yep.
And you're all, I don't know, but dude, you're in a good flow.
Yeah, no, I started, I don't know, it's kind of like a golf swing to me, like it clicked. And I think it was like, obviously the fans gave me that kind of security that like, mm-hmm. Okay, I'm cool. But also the riders, like they respect like what I'm saying. And you know, sometimes I get a little stewed sometimes, but like I just tell it like it is, and
yeah.
And I never try to disrespect, and they've all been appreciative of it. So I think that's where it's been like really like coming on for me, but I love it. Mm-hmm. I love it. And this TV thing is just another step of that.
Dude, you did awesome at the last broadcast.
Yeah, thank you. I mean, it was weird. I barely made the trip. I had a hard time trying to get there, and so I missed all the like prep to it, and so I got really thrown into it. It's the first time I ever done TV, so I feel way more relaxed this weekend, yeah. And it should be some good racing. So,
nice. All right, you ride anymore? When's the last time you rode a dirt bike?
I'm thinking about it. I'm just afraid, like when I ride, me and my boy Chad, we're gonna stir up some battles again. So, starting to get the flow and the juices back a little bit. So, we'll see. No comment.
All right. So, are you training?
Maybe for something.
Training for something.
Maybe something.
All
yeah,
right.
We'll
dude,
see.
How big did you get at one point?
Why you gotta go negative?
No, I'm just saying.
Why you gotta go negative?
You were living a good life for a while.
It wasn't even that. Like, I don't even know. Like, it wasn't just me. Like, all the greats. Like, we retire and all of a sudden we blow up.
Yeah.
I looked in the mirror, dude. I was, there might have been close to a two in front of my thing.
No, you were not 200
I'm telling
pounds.
You. I mean, maybe the scale was off, but I remember one time I jumped on that thing. Like jumped off. So yeah, but now, shoot, I'm back in the 140s again.
You
so.
Look like when you're racing, yeah.
Yeah, maybe skinnier than when I was racing. I should say enough right there. Yeah. Last time. Yeah, I'm coming back for Benny. I want Benny. I gotta redeem that.
Hey, how was it seeing Malcolm race outdoors?
I haven't really seen him that much.
Well, you see him today, but I mean,
yeah.
Dude, what has it been for him, 6 years?
Yeah, 6 years, and it's been 6 years. Yeah, it looks like 6 years. No, but I mean, they've been fighting with the bike all year.
Yeah.
And so I think it was like, it's hard to come back in the middle of the season, let alone Unadilla. And so for him, like, I mean, he's getting better, but these boys on another level, dude, they're showing up, so, and I don't know how, it's hot out here today, you see me sweating, and yeah, so we'll see, I think, give it all he got, and just, you know, go from next year.
Are the little boys riding?
Yeah, yeah.
Where are they on?
Stasics.
Stasics.
Stasics. Yeah, it's funny, because I show them YouTube, they don't care. You get autographs, they don't care. Daddy whooped that ass the other day on the bike, and they were like, oh, Dad, you're good on the motorcycle. I'm like, whatever. So now we got a thing, it's neck burns, whoever gets it. Like, so they'll win and be like, neck burn. So it's funny. So yeah, no, they're riding, which makes it more, makes me want to get.
You're gonna go Cobra 50 next, or?
I don't know. They're growing up, so whatever. I'll be a Pee Wee Dad.
Oh,
here,
the
so.
Pee Wee Dad.
Yeah.
Are you gonna break kickboards and throw shit?
Oh yeah. Yeah, of course. I gotta grow them up like I'm my dad. Like just leave them on the side of the track, hell with them, pick them up halfway down I-4, whatever. So, I'll be Pee Wee Dad.
Good seeing you, Dad.
You too, Don.
Do you know what time it is?
I hear you.
Hey, you got both your boys at the races today. How's that feel?
Man, it's been a long time since I had both of them at the same race.
Yeah.
One sitting on the couch announcing, the other trying to do a moto.
Is the one announcing going to bag on little brother a little bit?
I don't know. I think he kind of feels sorry for him.
All right. We're in California. I mean, you've spent plenty of time here. I always ask you, what's the best thing you ate this trip?
You know, Buffalo Wild Wing last night.
Yeah,
believe it or not. Black no, I actually right up here. At,
oh, okay.
It was awesome, dude. It was awesome.
Hey, have you noticed that at B-Dub-Dubs the service is dog shit?
Yes.
What is that? It's like they train the waiters to be shitty.
Yeah, they do. They do. They want you in and out. They don't want you hanging around no more.
So what's the flavor?
I ate honey barbecue.
Honey barbecue?
Yes, it was on point.
It was good.
Yeah, especially after a six pack of beer.
What's it like having Mookie back at the Nationals?
I think it's good for him, to be honest with you. I really wanted him. I've been pushing all year. I wanted him to race the National because a few things that you learn racing National that you don't have time to learn in Supercross.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, I'm all for it.
I mean, he's back in the top 10 where he should be.
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So the first race was a little grim.
Yeah. But,
I know he really didn't want to be there.
He didn't want to be there, but you know, I told him at the end of the day, people don't say Husqvarna got 17th. They say Malcolm Stewart.
Yeah.
And I was like, it's your name. You got to live with it.
Damn. Big James with the knowledge. Always dropping it. Good
Absolutely.
To see you, buddy.
Thanks.
Again, just watching, making sure it's just being done right. Hey,
what's up?
Tell me about the color scheme for this weekend.
This is a little throwback heritage to the heritage of Husqvarna. Fun to mix it up, final race of the year. I think it looks really cool.
It's like the Andy Brocho colors, right?
What's that?
That's an Andy Jefferson era.
Yeah, I think so. Maybe that's what we should call it.
Huh? Brocho flashback?
Yeah.
All right, so Jay, you're an artist, obviously.
Yes, I started doing motocross art in 1992. Mm-hmm. I met Jeremy McGrath, and chose to do a picture of him winning the outdoors when the magazine said he'd never win. And the picture depicted him winning the outdoor championship. And then from there, just been plugging away, watching the sport grow. And yeah, we got some superstars here now. So figured it's time to put down the best paintings I've ever done. So.
What's that other one?
This one is a Cliff Stenberg.
Oh. Yeah, you got all. Yeah, you missed some wrinkles, dude. Really yeah. So are these, is this oil?
These are acrylic. Acrylic on canvas, yeah.
Wow. What other things do you paint? Like,
I can paint anything. And I also tattoo.
Uh-huh.
And I do music production.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Your website?
My Instagram is the 13th J. THE13THJ.
All right. Does Jetson know this is coming?
No, he does not. I want to get hold of Myrtle and kind of surprise him. I don't want him to know that it's coming, and I want Myrtle to know ahead of time.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, he needs some more wrinkles. I got a selfie. You want me to come? why is Pedro working on your guy's bike?
I just wasn't. We had to get someone younger, stronger, and more talented. So hopefully he can take Marv to the top.
Take Marv to the top. So is he going to destinations with him as well?
I think he'll stay with Crowley. I think Jade will go with him for Team France. We brought back 2015 when Jade went with him.
So are you retired from the ranch? When's the last time you touched a spanner?
Tuesday.
Oh, okay. That's so. Yeah, the day's hottest commodity in there. Ice.
Yeah. 45 bags.
45 bags.
Yeah.
Is that enough to last all day? Are you going to make a...
We tested yesterday. We did 30 and we ran out.
Are you going to do a trash can full of ice water for Jason?
He's got his bathtub over there.
Oh, it's a bathtub?
Yeah.
Well, more sophisticated than the trash can.
Yeah. I'd like to put him in a trash can, but he won't let me.
So, Big B, the season is drawing to a close. Does this mean that your riding and cycling career will resume?
Yes. Starting Tuesday.
Tuesday? Where will you be riding?
The mean streets of Foothill Ranch.
Oh, cycling first.
Cycling
right?
First, yeah.
I haven't seen you on a dirt bike in a little while.
I am going to get a dirt bike as well next week.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Will it be an SR450?
It will probably not be an SR450.
Oh, but you have some ins to get some good parts.
I know
right?
Some people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you still ride in a turtleneck Enzo shirt?
Yes, me and Brian Barry still ride in your brother's turtleneck, long sleeve, black Enzo
shirt. At Elsinore.
At Elsinore.
Dino. What is your current role title here?
Engine technician.
Engine technician.
Okay, build all the engines, yeah.
I was thinking about it, like, you've had like 1,000 positions and jobs, like, through the years since, like, were you at Yamaha Troy W today?
No, I was on Motor World.
Motor World.
Suzuki, when they were Yamahas in the beginning, and then, yeah, this is my 32nd year.
32nd year.
Yeah.
Are you getting tired of motocross on the road yet?
Nah, I don't have to go to every race, so it's good, you know?
Oh,
I'm,
okay.
I rotate with a couple other guys at the shop, so I'm in and out five once a month, so it's good, you know?
So what are the, give me the 50 cent rundown on all the positions you got.
I was a mechanic for 15 years, and then the last, you know, I've been doing engine stuff, so I was at Honda for 9 years.
Uh-huh.
And then I went to Chad Reed's team for those couple years, and then ended up here, so it's been good.
Hey, your whole stint as an engine guy, was it all four-stroke, or was it two-stroke as well?
When I started doing the engine stuff, yeah, I was right when the four-strokes first came out in 2004, so that's when I started on the engine side.
Do you think there's more moving parts in a four-stroke?
Yeah.
Is it harder to get more power out of a four-stroke than a two-stroke, or how would you compare the two?
I mean, these things already have enough power as it is, you know, so it's kind of good. Like, we give it all we can, and a lot of times we're just detuning it, you know.
Detuning it,
yeah.
Isn't it crazy to think that, like, early in your career you're working with Jets, and now you're using a laptop?
Yeah, you're always trying to get as much out of it as you can, you know. So
but,
it's easy to detune it.
Yeah. What can you tell me about the 21 bike here? Special touch that you put on it?
Honestly, he's like the easiest rider I've ever had, you know.
Really?
They don't use the clutch, which is nice.
Yeah.
From some older riders that we had, but he loves the way it is right now. We haven't changed anything this whole year as far as motor, you know. He's tested some parts, but we have Brock to run through all that stuff.
Yeah, how is Tickle in
he's
that
awesome.
Position?
He's awesome. Tickle's awesome. Like, he was like one of the best things that we've done, you know, for our team to have him come along and have a nice, nice to have a guy that can run through all the stuff that you dynoed and you know, not waste these guys' time, right?
Yeah.
And Brock kind of knows what he wants.
So Brock requested to hold on to 20 for one more season. We're going to see him on the starting line?
Doubt it. I doubt it.
He's just sandbagging on people.
Yeah, he loves his role, so it's pretty good. Yeah, it's been good.
Good luck today.
Yeah, thanks.
You want to show me what you're going to eat today?
Yeah, we'll find out. I don't know what B has on the menu today.
What are you cooking today?
We're going to do a show today?
Yeah, we can.
Yeah. We're going to do a show today.
What does Brock eat?
Huh?
What Brock eats, Jeff? Yeah.
The last round, we might as well cap off 2022 with what will Brock eat next.
So, I told Jason I've been to Wood Ranch with him before, and he's ordered three dinners.
Holy cow.
Finished them all.
I know how much you eat, but to go pay for three dinners is different than crushing the truck.
You do have the best stock truck, though. I think you do.
He complains about that.
No.
What is he like? What is B not having the truck?
It's a long list.
I mean, I don't think anything, to be honest. I mean, we have if I want to make anything I want, I can pretty much make it for the most part. You know, each weekend he makes something different for the team guys. Jason and the riders like Joey this year had the same stuff every weekend. So for me, I just get creative. Maybe I'll mix some of the chicken that he made for Jason and Joey into a wrap or whatever. So, but we haven't done it in a couple weeks, so we can cap it off this weekend here at Paula.
Yeah, but he texts me during the week.
I want this and that.
Yeah, it drops a hint. Salmon sounds good this weekend. And roasted potatoes. And quagua.
What's the average grocery bill for a race?
Lately, because the costs are really high, it's been about like 700.
Whoa! How many baskets is that?
Two
baskets. Yeah. So you're the guy going through the market, pulling one and pushing one?
Yeah.
What's your poison? What's your favorite thing to buy?
Yesterday, I missed out on the hot. The hot sandwiches had to be better than my cold one.
Hot pastrami sandwiches.
Hot pastrami sandwiches?
Yeah.
What about like as a snack?
But you have to buy the whole chub of meat.
And he slices it.
And then slice it yourself.
Yeah.
And then cook it.
Does he have a slicer in there? One of those deli slicers? When are they coming? Dealership.
October.
October?
October.
Second half October?
Yeah. Yep.
When the race team guys getting on it?
Probably beginning of October?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. Can't wait, dude. It's the first time I've seen a new bike in a while.
That'll be good.
It looks
we'll have fun at the intro.
It looks small. Where are we going?
I can't tell you.
Red Bud?
It's top secret.
Let's go to Red Bud.
No.
Monster Mountain.
We've done that. We've done that. We'll do something different.
East Coast, West Coast?
We'll go to Haynes Canyon.
Yeah, okay.
Blue Bug.
Did you get all the barf off?
Yeah. He didn't barf this week.
He didn't?
Not yet. No, he's doing all right.
Where is it usually?
Normally, it was everywhere last week. I got on a bike after first practice. He goes, "Don't touch me." I puked all over everything. I'm like, "Oh, okay." And then I about puked on him.
Hey, I'm with Super Agent. I think you have the Golden Touch merch. Your guys are 1, 2, 3, and
I think we just got lucky this year.
Hey, how did you light a fire under the Japanese kid's butt?
I don't know. He had a rough Supercross. We had a rough Supercross, he was by
it. Was the Supercross, because he told me he was trying to ride more wide open, and then that bit him in the end,
I don't know, they're young, so like I think a lot of the young guys have that one, like, this didn't work, you know, because everyone's always trying to like find that next, like, what's that next tick to go that next level. So it was just a I think, just a bit of a miss in Supercross, you know. And that was the first series, like, kind of came into wanting to win the title.
Yeah.
You know, like, the first 2 years, like, you're like, okay, like, if I get a podium, if I get a win the year before, yeah, you could. He got that and a win the year before, so this was that year, like, this year for Joe was meant to be.
Yeah.
Like, he was meant to win. Like, well, he felt like he could get a win, and sometimes with that pressure, you miss what helped you win, right? So, wasn't that big of a deal.
What clicked in the last 2 months?
I think he's relaxing, riding like how he does. I think he's aggressive at the right times, you know.
How do you have to handle the three kids differently?
I don't know. I'm the biggest kid amongst them all, so, like...
Biggest idiot.
Oh, there we go. So I probably, you know, we all get along, but we've all been working together since no one had heard their name, so it's all pretty normal and pretty fun. Well, we keep it light. We keep it really light.
So, as you ever, you know, I see videos of them in the backseat of your rental car together, fucking off, but has there ever been any tension or not?
No.
Your pals, right?
Yeah, like,
even with Joe Carson Hunter?
No, like, I think, like, and no one's like, gone are the days where it's like hammerhead, like, screw everyone kind of thing. I think that's wasted energy, right? The calories on race day. Yeah, once you're out there, it can get heated, but like, I kind of feel like those three in particular like each other and race each other fair and clean. And,
We've been together a long time.
I know. Long before anyone knew the name.
Did the video of your little girl flipping you off?
Oh, it's non-stop. It's non-stop.
Huh? Are you doing Vaseline?
Yeah. I'm trying to.
This is for personal use.
Yeah.
What are you doing? Is that to catch?
Yeah, just
dirt?
In case something gets in there.
Yeah.
Oh, but you gotta be careful. You can't put much in when it's this hot. It'd be like liquid.
Yeah. Then you get the Vaseline in your eye, right?
Yeah, you don't want to do that.
Okay.
Have you ever done that swap?
No. I haven't experimented with Vaseline too much.
That's fair.
So, does anyone wear the one without outriggers? Everyone wears a Prospect?
No.
Prospect is the best goggle made.
Good, yeah, but actually Maximus wears the Fury goggle, so it's pretty close.
Mm.
And Savachi.
Who is or what's the lens preference today?
Ooh, there's a lot of different ones out here today. I'd say it's still majority clear.
Clear?
Yeah, but there's gray, there's light sensitive, there's amp. We have a lot of different ones out today.
Do you have any racers that look for the Alessi Intimidator Iridium?
Nobody wants to wear chrome when they race.
That's a glamorous thing, right?
Yeah, I don't know. It's more about the look.
The look.
Than the function.
Yeah. Who has the most peculiar goggle setup?
Everybody's stock right now, basically,
really?
Right out of the box.
No one wants like fucking 52 teraops or anything?
No, everything's pretty standard at the moment, which is nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, everybody's pretty much right out of the box.
Yeah. You know,
except for you.
Oh, look, out of the box, light sensitive.
Light sensitive.
Yeah. New pair of goggles every time they're on the track?
Yeah.
Do you guys get in trouble when they throw their goggles to the fans?
No, they don't, except in practice, because I like to reuse them for parade laps. So if they want a fresh parade lap goggle, don't throw it away in practice. Yeah. And then after that, I don't really care. I try to get back what I can. But.
So what brand?
Maxi
pads?
Kotex Light Days.
Kotex Light Days.
Regular though, don't get the long and don't get the scented. The scented's
gross.
What
about the ones with wings?
Scented's gross, dude. Yeah. The ones with the wings, nah.
Like, they're gonna
end up cutting
the
wings anyway, so. Yeah. Kotex, man.
Do you send your wife to go buy those?
No.
Or do you go buy
them? No, I do it.
And you buy multiple
awkward.
Boxes, right?
Yeah, I try to get ahead so I don't have to do it often.
Do you maybe go to Sam's Club and buy a case?
Yeah.
Hey, I'll let you know when he's eating banana today.
We were done.
No, we were in.
Oh boy.
How's it going?
Oh boy, it's good.
Huh?
It's good. We're going good.
What time do you race?
We raced yesterday.
Why are you geared up?
It's a parade lap, so I get to go around the lap, around the track.
Oh, it's a combine parade lap?
Yeah.
Are you gonna do a trick?
I mean,
Lazy boy.
We're gonna try.
That's my vote.
We're gonna try.
I think maybe you should take a banana in your hand and go reach up and just smash in the front of your head. What do you think?
Or maybe like tape a beer can to like the top of my helmet or something. Yeah.
All right, so what was the result yesterday? I saw the qualifying.
Yeah, so qualifying was P3 yesterday, and then...
He's like a pro already, he says P.
P3. Yeah.
Not, I didn't qualify third, no.
No, no. P3. P3. So yeah, P3 in qualifying, and then first moto, I was running fifth. I crashed, tipped over, caught back up to eighth. So I got eighth first moto, mm-hmm. and then second moto, bad start, got into sixth. And then by the time I got into sixth, fifth was already gone.
So 8-6.
Yeah. So 8-6. 8-6 for seven. Yeah.
That's not bad.
No, it's not bad at all.
Has it changed your luck?
No.
Not yet?
Actually, we don't know yet. We're gonna go through today and we're gonna test the luck a little bit.
Oh, okay. Because I'm waiting for that news. Waiting for the
2026, what do you mean?
Did you just sign her forehead?
Yeah. She also said to call her and
can I see your forehead? I think you gave that kid your pen. It's in your pocket? Nice. Hey, tell me about this necklace.
What about it? You know, it's some pearls. We have, it's not a real one. Hell no, I wouldn't pay that much. Those things are expensive, so.
Is it an angel? Is it a Catholic thing?
Angel. Yeah, baby angels. Huh? Wait, you're not liking it?
No, I like it.
I was going to say,
it
what's
probably
your worst
less than the big metal one, right?
Oh, yes, it does a lot, that's for sure. I didn't run it while I was racing, though, so.
Oh, okay.
It's silly.
Do you like my shirt, Andy?
See.
Huh?
See.
I'm a supporter. I have to complain. I complained to Dino on the line though. I said, I want to complain to customer service. It should have been available in a white option for days like today.
Well, you've got to break sweat. There's no point in being out in the sun if you're not sweating. Right?
I guess you're right.
You know.
I figured of all people, you'd tell me to man up.
You know, sweat only lasts for so long, then you run out of sweat. So. Why worry about it? As long as you're not standing too close to anybody, you'll be okay.
Okay. How do you feel? What are the emotions going through your head knowing that this was the last national you're going to root for your kid at?
No, I'm so happy, man. Happy. I'm happy about it, yeah.
Happy they escaped motocross in one piece.
Alright. And not really happy about it. Just his body don't let him do it anymore, so no more trips to the hospital.
Yeah. Well, I certainly miss you living in California and our rides at Greer Ranch.
Oh, I miss it so much, too. I haven't ridden for a year and a half. So, but last week I took a spell at Uggs. I went to a track in Florida.
Uh-huh.
It was all jumpy. It was like a mini supercross track.
Uh-huh.
And what? And it's gaps.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's 50 feet or whatever. Not too bad. It's peaky as shit.
Yeah.
Got the first one. No problem. Second one, third one, cased it, caught the back wheel on the back.
Oh no.
My God. Put the bike in the van and said, that is enough.
Done.
Yeah.
It's a little more vicious than the Wednesday afternoon lunchbox tales with Tom Mylan.
Yes, but I need to start cycling more and get stronger again.
Yeah.
But again, Florida, it's not as good for mountain biking and this and that.
It's flat, just, isn't it? Yeah. Well, if you come back to California, I got a bike for you.
Oh, excellent.
So we can ride.
There you are. That'd be good. Excellent. I appreciate that.
See
ya. You don't want to be on camera or
what? He said slip his booty off and you ran away. So is she your booty?
Just slip it off.
Mini dad. Mini dad. Give me the mini dad story. Sold your house.
I sold my house.
To travel on the road?
Well, to travel the West Coast for the year. Brittany still has a lot of houses that she's doing design work on. So we're buying a smaller house in Havasu, just something easy that we can leave vacant for a while and not be such a big deal. My son wants to chase the dream for a little while and I've held off as long as I can. And now it's the point to where I know he's gonna resent me when he gets older if I don't give him that opportunity. So I'm giving him a year to show me progress. He's not gonna win in a year, I know that, but give me progress. And
off-road or moto? Off-road or moto?
Moto.
Moto, oh shit.
If he can show me progress in 365 days, I will go even more. We'll figure out, we'll buy land somewhere, we'll do something else. If he sucks at the 366th day, pick a different sport. I'm not going to be the one that forks over money over and over and over and over for, you know, chasing an empty dream. So I'm at that point to where I would love for him to make it. I'd love for him to do it. I'll give everything I have into it. All I want is progress. That's it. Not winning. I mean, I'm rough, but you got to think this is a lot of money every year to race this sport. So, and he's going to be 11, and at the end of the day, if he turns 18, he's going to waste between now and then if I let him just chase an empty dream. Hey, reality is reality, man.
Mini dad, no
fun. No. See, I don't have to live it. I don't have to live through him. True. I already lived it.
You already lived it.
So now it's just like, just being Wilson. Peace out.
Okay.
That's the end, huh?
Where's he at?
That's it.
Oh, he's riding around.
He's riding around.
There's Miss Supercross.
Today, we're healthy.
God, you seriously can't live. You can't live that down, okay? You can't live that down.
Whoa. Dude, you did it, man.
Yeah.
How does it feel?
It's nice now. Today was hot as all heck. There was no gifts about today. It was the whole day, like you had to go do it. There was no rolling around, there's a cushion. Like you had to be the guy today, and we were able to do that, so rad.
I can't recall you ever looking so gnarly, facial expression-wise, on the starting line. I mean, dude, I took a picture of you and I like cracked my lens. You were so mean.
Yeah, I mean, it was game time. I mean, Moto 1 was a huge deal for me, but then Moto 2, I'm like, I still got my work cut out for me. There's a lot of other good guys out here, and I still at least have to get second.
Yeah.
And I was a little bit worried at the beginning of that second Moto on where I was in the first lap.
When you saw him laying on the ground, with your head?
Well, it was a sigh of relief, but I still had a lot of racing left.
Yeah.
And then I had Jason in the front, so I knew Chase would make a push back to us.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, I need to get by Jason. So that's all I was focusing on at that point once Chase was down. Like, I got to make a run to the front of the race as fast as I can because I know Chase is going to be coming again. So Jason put up a good fight. Mm-hmm. And then my focus was to try to get around him as fast as I could too.
Yeah. Okay, coming into this race, everybody's like talking about how gnarly Chase is here.
Yeah.
Right? And I think, how did that weigh on you? Was it just motivation or?
Well, I knew he'd be strong here, but I also knew round one for me was basically a wash.
Mm-hmm.
I've said it before, I'm not great. I'm not great at round one, just period. And when I look at my whole career, I'm not great at round one. I usually have to make some sort of bike adjustment. And I was behind there. We changed a lot of our bike setup from round one to say round two, three. I forget where we stopped messing around with the bike, but and then to this point. So I knew it really didn't matter, even though from the outside looking in, it probably looked like he had more advantage, but I knew I'd be right there with them this weekend.
Yeah, I think, was this the classic case of the experienced veteran champion rising to the occasion over the rookie with no experience?
Yeah, the first one is really hard. And when I just think back to my situation, or my first one, like I didn't sleep the way I slept last night before my first opportunity at championship. So yeah. I slept fine last night, but knowing that I had to go execute anyway.
Mm-hmm. Does it feel good to go out on top? I mean,
oh my gosh.
Supposedly your last national season, right?
Yeah, it's more than likely.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, all I have is Supercross signed up for next year.
Yeah.
I mean, Yamaha is kind of knocking on my door, and but it's probably like a 90-10 scenario, maybe 95% that I'm done.
Yeah.
And this whole year, it's tough to have these years, so if I decide to step away, I'd be totally satisfied with it.
Yeah. Last question. I finally saw the new bike over there.
Ooh, it was out.
How badass is it?
it's a big deal. And the biggest deal is the weight. You can feel it. That's the first thing I said. I mean, that's what they told me, is like everyone comes off the track and they tell you, oh my gosh, like left to right and lean angle, starting the transition to the turn is so much better. And that's That's what I felt. So I'm excited for Supercross because turning is everything. So yeah, should be good.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
All right, it was hot as balls today at Fox. We had a good time. Did you have a good time?
I had a good time. I was wondering if I could maybe work out like a Supercross only contract. For No, it was fun. It was hot though.
Yeah. Anyway, that's it for this week's vlog. Next week, Chase Curtis takes over because yes. I'm going.
Jet skis every day, guys. I'm sorry.
It's life on two rudders. Yeah. Oh yeah, I'm going on vacation. Taking the fam to Italy. So see you next time.